Yes, you are.
Hello, everyone. Happy Monday. Hope you had a wonderful weekend. Give you guys a minute or two to hop on. I'm gonna fix my situation so I can see all you guys. That was a trick question. I don't get to see any of you guys.
Darla says that February 22nd is National Margarita Day. How did we not know this?
Margarita Day! We love margaritas. Lorraine, it's Margarita Day!
What?
It's Margarita Day! National Margarita Day!
I
know! Lorraine forgot her margarita at home, guys.
All right. We're at 150 and going.
150 and going? Alright, I guess I'll stop dancing.
Oh.
Alright, the dancing will come to an end. Calm, Amanda.
Julie says your hair looks so pretty today.
Oh, thanks. It's my natural hair. Thanks, Julie. So, I have a joke. I'm going to start off with a joke today. You guys ready for a joke?
We're ready.
It's not the funniest one I've ever picked, but that's okay. Why couldn't the leopard play hide and seek? Because he was always spotted.
I think we've done that one.
Oh, man. A lot of the ones that I was finding are quite inappropriate. They have me laughing, but I couldn't do it. Okay, so announcements for this week. Tomorrow we have Baby Lot Club. So that will be fun. And then we have on Wednesday, Main Street. Where's my brain at?
Please hold. She's gone. Did everybody have fun at Garden Guild on Saturday? There we go.
Speed walking. So we have our Main Street class. So we are going to be doing the embroidery portion of the Main Street pillow on Wednesday. We have made a couple of announcements at this point, but I will announce it again. Christine and myself did film a video on how to prepare yourselves for that class if you are participating. We have emailed that to the attendees in the class. If you recently signed up since the last announcement and you would like to view that, please feel free to contact one of the stores and let us know that you are in need of that email. It is a Zoom class, so it's just a recording that you can watch before class to better know how to prepare yourself for Wednesday. Thursday, we have OESD's freestanding lace event, which is a free event. It starts at 10 a.m. and you'll learn how to do a lot of the freestanding lace tips and tricks to show you how to not struggle with doing freestanding lace and kind of learn a little bit of history about the freestanding lace skill and have fun with that. In order to register for that, you just go to our website on our homepage. There's a flyer on our homepage. So you just click on that. It takes you to another screen where you can then register for the class.
So those of you that are asking about the prep class that Christine and Amanda did, that email should have gone out last Monday. So it wasn't something that was like within the last couple of days. You're going to have to dig back into your emails from a week ago.
Yes. If we need to resend, it's not a problem. So just give our stores a call and let us know that you're signed up for the event and that you would like to watch that prep class. They'll reach out to me and I'll send it to you guys. And then on the 25th, which is Friday, we have the Baby Lock Machine Basics. So if you're new to sewing, just recently purchased a Baby Lock machine, and you want to go over threading your bobbin, and some of the basic necessities on how to work your machine, that would be an excellent class for you. That class is also at 10. And then on Saturday, we have the Floriani Virtual Club with Miss Nancy.
Good class.
And I am the lucky model of today's project. Ooh. Ah, what's inside the bag? Happy Easter! I'm just showing you this because it was in the bag. That's all. Christine and myself are going to be teaching a class on the Happy Easter. We are going to be teaching this as a different type of class than your traditional bench pillow. We figured you've done the Twilight bench pillow, the Ginger's Kitchen, Luck of the Gnome, then we're having the Main Street. So we're going to change this one up a little bit and do this as a wall hanging, or you could treat it as like a table runner. So that will be fun. Looking forward to that one. You're up, my dear.
All right.
And we'll announce the winner here in a little bit. Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
All right. So the cool thing about this bag is that it comes from a panel.
All panel.
So technically everything that you need is right here. You have your front and back here strips, and then a little pocket to go on the inside of the bag if you so choose. However, that is boring.
Yes. Who wants a white inside of a bag?
Really boring. Plus, I mean, white on the inside of a bag. Let's think about that.
It gets dirty.
So, when that panel came, we also had two other fabrics come in. So this nice striped fabric, which is what I'm going to put on the inside of my bag. And then another coordinating fabric, but most of it is white, so that's why I didn't use it to line. But I did throw it into the kit there for you guys. So you get the panel, the striped fabric, and that butterfly fabric all together. Comes to $18.99. And you have you have all you need plus a little more. Okay?
Yes, go ahead. Go for it, girlfriend.
So with all of the tons and tons of spools of thread that we have when we do events and even doing these lives and stuff, we had a lot of opens, but still had a lot of life left on them. So what we kind of did was we put five spools together. Typically Floriani thread is $5.99 a spool. But we did put five in a package and made the whole thing $15. So we do only have a certain amount of these. So if you're interested in them, just put your name down. But I believe tomorrow we will have Kate and Patrick draw those names as to who will then win the
ability to purchase them.
Yeah, yeah. But, I mean, they are not all the same. You know, these two aren't even anywhere close. So they are all out there with a bunch of different colors and a bunch of different... bunch of different colors, yeah.
Lots of different options.
So, with that being said, I already, you guys don't want to see me cut. but I thought it was cool that the panel even has your instructions, which is kind of handy.
It is very handy.
So, like I said, I am lining the bag, so I'm not going to just jump right in. So the other cuts of fabric that you get in your bundle is a half yard cut, which is pretty much what's gonna fit on the back. I've already pinned the front of my tote after I've cut it out, and the back and the lining, I've already pinned those together. So now I'm just gonna stitch them.
Gonna stitch them?
Gonna stitch them.
You gonna stitch them? I'm gonna get this chair.
Yeah, I was gonna say, what are you doing?
So you're just doing a quarter of an inch?
Yep, just doing a quarter of an inch.
Are you leaving an opening anywhere?
Nope, don't need to.
Don't need to leave an opening anywhere because the lining's already on it.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, how smart.
See? And so I'm not a fancy quarter of an inch footer. footer. I usually just actually use my J foot, run my edge along the side of my foot, and use a quarter of an inch selection on my quilting tab. How is the pocket going to work?
You'll just have to wait and see.
You'll see.
Mm-hmm. Yep. I love that you guys are smarter than me sometimes. So, I'm just going to stitch this side and then I'll show you the pocket. Okay, because y'all are just so much smarter than me.
I'm going to go slow. Slow spinning. I've gotten yelled at too much. For making you ladies sick, so I'm going slow.
Pulling a Patrick?
Making people sick?
Yeah.
I'm, you know what? I'm a fast person.
Okay. Here it is.
Spinning again?
Nope.
Don't spin.
Okay. So. Okay, so here's your little pocket piece. It wanted me to either serge or zigzag the top, but I still think that it wouldn't have been pretty.
The look of this with it just folded over is nice.
Yeah, so what I did was I folded it over probably a little bit less than a quarter, folded it again, and then just stitched it. That way, you know, when you see that opening in your purse or in your bag, it'll be nice and cute. And then they wanted you to press on every side about half an inch. So I've kind of done that, a little bit of prep work. And so then it just says to pin in place where desired. Leaves a lot of...
wherever you'd like.
A lot of freedom there. So kind of what I did was I took the pin that I just lost. Here it is. So it's going to be a little tricky now that I've sewn one side together, but
Judy wants you to know that she loves your nails.
Thanks. I used my pin and I kind of visualized the center of my design here that's on the front, and with my fabrics lined up, so that's kind of the center to me. Maybe a little bit down.
Oh, thanks, Karen. Thanks for attending the class.
Okay, so now that it's sticking out the back here.
Can't really see it.
No. Woohoo.
If you get to do that, I should probably be able to tell my naughty jokes.
Okay. You have a boy, I don't. So that's kind of where I want the center of my pocket to be.
And so it says to pin your pocket in place where desired, on the inner side, which for the directions is going to be the inner side of your panel, not on your lining, but we're going to do the lining here today. And and then we're going to sew the side and the bottom. So I'm going to have to unpin.
Yay.
It's better than unsewing, though.
It is. So, Sally, to answer your question about the turning rods, for Hoppy Easter with the bunny ears are actually not that large, so I don't think that those would be needed. And in Kimberbell's instructions, you're just using the, like a turning tool, whether that's the RNK or the OESD, which are the two that we sell in the store. Either one of those options are going to work. I'm not sure that the fast tubes, the turning system would be necessary for that project.
Okay.
Do we have these fabrics still on the bolt? Mm-hmm. So ladies, we can show you the fabrics on the bolt. Just keep in mind that we do need to fulfill the orders that are for the bundles in order to make the bag or just to have the bundles before we cut yardage. But you can certainly put in your request to have some of this fabric.
It's been a few weeks since I actually did the bags. So
I'm going slow, ladies.
Apologize.
Hi, Pat Jackson. Oh, thanks, Sally. I appreciate that. Glad you were able to attend. How big is the bag? While you do that, I'm going to go measure the bag. Okay. We're going to go measure the bag, ladies. So this is an inside pocket. Yes, Patricia Hunter, it is. All right. So we are trying to do this one-handed, so forgive me, ladies. Bottom of the bag. It's about 20 inches by 17. And then here are the bolts. So this is the bolt that has your panel on it. The bolt with the butterflies. And the bolt with the stripes. All right, going slow, going slow. Yes, Pet Kim, I will show you the bundle. Bundle here. You have your butterfly fabric, the stripes, and then the panel piece. And they do, the panel has slightly different feel and the texture of the material. Yeah, it's a little bit more canvassy. How much are the bundles?
$18.99. So you get the panel and then the two other fabrics is a half yard cut of each. Okay, so I missed a step. when we pressed half an inch, I was supposed to also sew that down. So now that I've done that, I've got my pocket now in place.
Sit upside down.
Upside down. I swear my life. I swear to God, that's it. Okay, now that it's pinned in place, we're going to sew the bottom and the edges.
Is there enough fabric so that you could line the pocket?
If you were going to line the pocket with the same fabric, the same,
The stripes,
then no, there will not. But you could always do the pocket in the butterfly, and then you would have...
But honestly, I think with this size pocket, yeah, you're really not going to see the inside of it.
It's only going to be that big, you guys.
Yeah. The opening is quite small. That's okay, Rose. The kit is $18.99. You get the panel to make the bag, and then you get the striped fabric and the fabric with a butterfly, and you get a half yard cut out of the two fabrics, the stripe and the butterfly. Hi, Patty. Oh, sorry. You need me to move it?
No, I just was glad I didn't just push it. So with this being a pocket, I would definitely reinforce here up at the top with having your hand and phone and who knows what else you're going to be putting in there. Snacks.
So, Patricia Hunter... this bundle is all one. So in one bundle, it has this fabric here. This is your panel to make the bag. And then you have the striped fabric that you can use as your lining if you'd like. And you also get the butterfly fabric as a coordinating fabric that you can choose what you would like to do with that. But... that kit is $18.99, but you get all three. So there's not a separate kit for just the butterfly.
All right, I'm going to repin here again.
You're welcome. Everyone have a good weekend. It's actually really nice outside.
Yeah, it is. Windy though this morning. Crazy windy.
Yep. Hi, Cheryl. We miss you.
Cheryl?
Cheryl Johnson.
Oh, other Cheryl. Hi, Cheryl.
Going slow.
Keep shocking the bejesus out of myself.
So, the bundle is going to give you the panel to make the bag that Cindy's doing for the video today. And in the bundle, with the panel, you also get this striped fabric in a half a yard and this butterfly fabric in half a yard. And it is $18.99.
I'm more concerned about.
Your instructions are on the panel. Once you cut everything as directed on your instructions here, you have your instructions left over, which is kind of nice. But once I get my... one hand. So this is the bag. Maybe it's better to show it on the floor. So this is the bag, ladies and gentlemen. And trying to show you the pocket in here. So this tag here, this bag belongs to, my name's going to go right there. Kate says, hi everyone, cute project, Cindy. The kit is $18.99.
I thought you said the kid.
The kid. The bundle of fabric is $18.99 and you'll be able to make this bag. Sarah says, you rock, sissy. Super cute. Hi, Amanda. Hi, Sarah.
Hi, Sarah.
Glad you have the CD, Charlene. I won't track it down for you anymore. Otherwise, I'll be at your house. Yes, it is very springy.
Mm-hmm. This makes me happy looking at it.
Rosalie, we can get a kit set aside for you here. Deborah, yes. So these CDs that were the bonus CDs for this last weekend's Garden Guild event, that was our first Kimberbell event of the year. And yes, the bonus CDs should be at all three locations. So if you participated in this weekend's event and spend $100 or more on Kimberbell product, you would qualify for getting that bonus CD for free. And this is for those of you who participated in the Kimberbell Garden Guild event this last Saturday.
All right, going back up here.
Going slow, going slow, going slow.
Okay, so now that our lining's all stitched in place, next instruction is to fold your bag in half, right sides together, and make sure it's all lined up.
I'm leaving you after this video. I'm going over to Charlene Kreidler's.
Oh, yeah.
And we're gonna sell the bonus samples for Garden Guild. Oh, okay. Are you gonna be able to live without me here?
I don't know. I mean, so yes. Now I think I'm just gonna do. Pin up here and pin up here to keep my corners together.
Pat, to answer your question, a lot of what we are doing on our live videos that are projects embroidery related, you are definitely able to participate in a lot of the live videos that we do. I think most commonly, as far as like a sew-along, is going to be the Kimberbell fill-in-the-blank program. I'm not sure if you're aware of what that is. So, Cheryl Jennings, if you don't spend $100, but we want to, can you buy it? No. So, Cheryl Jennings just brought up a wonderful question about the bonus CD for the Kimberbell event. We cannot sell those discs. They are pretty much a gift from Kimberbell when you purchase $100 or more on Kimberbell product and you've attended a Kimberbell event, you are then able to receive a free bonus CD. So it's only if you attend the event and spend $100 or more on Kimberbell product are you able to obtain that disc, but you cannot buy it.
All right, so now it wants you to sew your two long sides together. Just sew it closed at half an inch.
At a half of an inch, not a quarter, right?
Yeah.
Right. So, Pat, if you're interested in some materials that you can use on your Pathfinder, if you want to give me a call at 720-440-9654, I would be happy to help you get some stuff set up for you. My whole screen.
Did you break it?
Look.
Oh.
Okay, that's better. Pat, my name is Amanda. And yes, Anne, we are allowing in-store shoppers. Do you want to tell them about the garage sale? Okay. Hello from SoCal. Hello, Evelyn from Heiko. You're welcome, Pat. Look forward to talking to you.
Okay, so now over here.
Am I turning?
Yeah.
I'm going slow. Do you guys like the fact that I'm giving you a warning now before I move?
So now that we've done the seams on the side, we're going to prepare our straps by folding in half lengthwise. Okay, everybody, our car has got a broken windshield. How
about we blow off some steam? Now punch, now chip. Mr. Blanks, fold in half. So Evelyn, we're making a bag, and this is being made out of a panel. Let me try and maneuver this while she's folding in half and doing some pressing.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Good job.
Hey, guess what? This will work out great.
Oh, no. You were so lucky that that worked.
I know. All right, guys, I had to put you down, and I used the iron to do so. So this is the panel, and this is how you are going to make your bag. So the top right-hand corner right here where my finger is hovering over are your instructions. Just below that right here is your pocket for your bag. So on the instructions, it gives you your cutting instructions, and you can see on here that there's some words on here for further instruction that falls in line with the instructions at the top right hand corner here. So in your kit or bundle, I should say, you'll get the panel. So this piece of fabric right here that we have on the floor, and you'll also receive the lining material. And you'll also receive this butterfly fabric as well. So these two fabrics that are the lining with the stripes and this butterfly fabric, you're going to have a half yard cut of each of these two fabrics to go along with your panel. And that is $18.99. When the bag is finished, it looks like this. Very cool. So we have your panel, and these two strips here are your the top part of your bag over here. So everything you need to make this bag is in your bundle.
Except for the goodies to fill it.
Okay, I'm gonna put you guys down again to pick this up so we're not walking on it. How long are these strips, Cindy? Do you know?
About 27 and a half.
All right, so the strips are about 27 and a half. If you'd like, there's no problem with making them just a little bit shorter. Lori says it would make a great shopping bag. You're right. No. It might just be the cord. So she just folded the strips in half, and then she's taking both sides and folding the raw edges towards that inner fold. Pat, to answer whenever is a good time to call. After we're doing the live video, you can call us whenever. It right now is 2:47 in Colorado. And we do close at 6 o'clock, Monday through Friday, and 10 to 4 on Saturdays. You could certainly do that, Judy. Or what you could do is you could use the template that's on your panel for your pocket. To cut out another pocket, make two identical pockets, have them on one side, have them one on each side. Cindy looks like, what?
I didn't hear the whole thing. I just said she's not seeing.
Okay.
I don't know the whole story.
Sounds good, Pat. Hello, ladies.
I think I did the straps on that one a little different.
Yeah. Yes, Sheila, the instructions are actually a part of the panel. So I just had the panel out on the floor, but this is your panel folded up, and your instructions are right on here. Auto parts.
We're just gonna do what they say, but. Okay, so they are saying to fold and press your strip in half wrong sides together, okay? Reopen, now fold your raw edges into that middle crease that you just made and press. And then it wants you to stitch a quarter of an inch. Okay. So for me, having this right here is a little,
I don't like it. So what I did on mine, if you can see here, is I, instead of doing the raw edge to the center, I actually folded it down as small as I could make it, and I stitched that closed. And then I took that finished edge and then folded it into the middle crease, just because it just looked a lot cleaner. For time's sake, though, I'm going to do it like the instructions. So don't hate me.
Gotten a couple people who say that they like that better and what you did was better. Hi Barbara, the panel bundle is $18.99.
Just, I think aesthetically, it makes me feel better. Plus having that raw edge, you know, like while you're while it's rubbing on your shoulder and stuff, like it could fray.
You know what I just love is that our customers watching our live video are helping answer the questions.
That's awesome. Yeah. Anybody want a part-time job? And totally not on purpose, I just chose a cream-themed
thread.
A cream thread is really what I was trying to say. I don't know where the theme came from. And you really can't even see the stitching in here, which is very nice.
So, Patsy, we do not have a thread list for Main Street because we have used the... The Red, White, and Bloom thread kit. This is actually made, hence the name, Red, White, and Bloom. But this thread kit here, works for both the new quilt that will be released from Kimberbell in March. Guys, that's right around the corner. But that will work for both the quilt and the Main Street bench pillow. So we have, used that, as well as the colors in that box. We do recommend having a white and a black thread. On the events calendar, there is a supply list on, it is glide thread, yes. So on the events calendar for the Main Street bench pillow, underneath the picture is a PDF, excuse me, have a hiccup. an attachment that you can print, and it has your needed supplies for that project. And on there, there's a Floriani color that we are requesting for us to use. Again, this is up to your preference on your pillow, but it is a navy blue thread that blends in with that navy linen texture fabric in order to stitch the eyelets. So take a look at that supply list, and that thread color will be on there for you, ladies. That's a good idea, Rose Brown.
What does Rose Brown say?
They're just giving a lot of suggestions on like different ways to do what you did on your sample. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of same outcome but different ways of doing it. Mm-hmm. And Jan, yes, the Hoppy Easter fabric kit can be made into a wall hanging.
It's one of the cool things about Kimberbell.
Going slow. The thread set, I believe, is $37.99. No?
Oh, maybe that is with the discount, but it's like
$47.99. So now that it's been announced that today is Margarita Day, who's going to indulge? Keep forgetting to put my hand on the table. Shaken sewing syndrome. There are 10 spools of thread in the set. Michelle, what are you curious on the cost? What item? All right, hold on, Liz. Let me look at it myself. All right, supply list. Oh no, Liz, you were right. So the conversion chart for Kimberbell. Mm-hmm. So if you know what? I'm going to find the link for the thread conversion and I'm going to post it to our Facebook so that you guys will have access to it. The thread set, so this is just answering some more questions. So we have, these are open spools that have been used for either the live videos, classroom projects, but they are very new but opened Above and Beyond Threads, 5 spools to a package, and they are $15 for the 5 spool set. So what we are doing with these is you can express your interest in these as to we only have a limited supply. And based off of the names listed, we're going to have Kate and Patrick do a drawing tomorrow during the live video so that we can announce then who will have the ability to purchase these thread kits. Let me get caught up on some of these questions. 47.49 is the cost of the Red, White, and Bloom thread set. It is glide thread and there are 10 spools to the package. Okay, so this is the website for the thread conversions. So kimberbell.com/thread-conversions. And it will take you to Kimberbell's site here. And it's going to show you a swatch of the fabric, the thread you would want for glide, Hemmingworth, Isochord, Robinson Anton, Floriani, and Exquisite. So that is going to show you all those different thread options for the fabrics that are available through Kimberbell. Again, I will take this link and I will post it to our Facebook so that if you are having trouble getting to it, you can just get it at the click of a button so we can get that taken care of. But if you have those fabrics, then you would just know, you know, what thread name, whether what brand of thread that you have, so you can check to see if you already have it. Okay, so one other thing that I wanted to show you is on our website, we have a new button. So next to blog at the very end here is garage sale. Right now, Matt is in the process of adding a few things on there. So if you just go to the garage sale button here, it'll pop up this page and you can click on garage sale. It gets bigger when you hover over it. And there's some really cool items on here. So there's an inspirational guide for an Alissimo, some trolleys for Ovation Sergers. So there's some really cool projects on there, but they are greatly discounted and Matt is still working on getting some more products posted on the garage sale. So let's go check in with Cindy. I'm trying to go really slow. Say hi.
Hi.
I was telling them about the garage sale.
Did you show them the tab?
I did, yep.
Cool. Yeah, I'll try and put more stuff up each week.
Okay.
So I used the Airlite batting for the pre-quilting on the blocks.
Okay. So, kind of done a few things. You had your straps and you had your bag. They wanted you to not poke yourself like I just did. Take the top of your bag and fold about 3/4 of an inch once and then again towards the lining of your bag. You don't want to go towards, you know, the front of your bag. But do that and pin, and then to place your straps. They don't give you any specific dimensions or whatever as to where to place it. I kind of just went from the edge of my bag, went 2 inches in, and that's where I put my
So you can really place them wherever you want.
You can definitely do whatever you want.
You can make it even longer by putting them closer together.
Yeah. I don't know why you would want to do that. But yeah, definitely. And then I clip those in place. So once I've done all of that, then I am going to, in the raw edges of my straps, I went all the way into that first fold that I made. So that way they're like in there really well when I stitch this all closed also. And I'm gonna sew around the whole opening up here. I don't know if I'm just an overachiever or whatever it is, but I'm actually gonna stitch up here and then I'm gonna stitch down here too.
Make those handles super strong.
Yeah, yeah.
I got the hiccups though. Time for more coffee.
I haven't even had any coffee today.
Oh, I would die.
I had some orange juice. That's definitely not gonna work for me.
He's on the phone right now, Michelle, but I will certainly tell him you said hello. Patty Hunter, are you wanting the disc, the fabric kit?
All the above.
If you wouldn't mind clarifying that for us. Roxy, the cabinet here is called the Kiwi Cabinet, and we love it. It comes with this pad on here to do your pressing. It comes with this little mat here to do your cutting, and there's some drawers in there. Has some nice wooden little spindles in there so that you can put your thread, and they don't go anywhere. That's one of my favorite things about it. Those don't come out. So a drawer here, and then one with a little bit more depth to it. As you can see, it's our storage facility for some extra items. Yes, Vicki. Kimberbell has a lot of different options for the quilting designs. The ones that we're using for Main Street and the red, white, and bloom are going to be called the Patriotic. And Kimberbell just released the border quilting options. That's something that's new. And I'm sure we'll talk about that more at a later time. But there's Halloween ones, there's St. Patrick's Day ones. There's quite a few, and the quilting designs are $6, and I believe that the border ones are $11. I could be wrong on that, though. Thanks, Diane. We sure enjoy it. And if my hand continues to stay on the counter while she sews, you will experience shaking sewing syndrome. Yeah, Vicki, I saw the last part of your question. If you go to mykimberbell.com, you'll be able to add to cart all of the different options you're interested for the quilting and have access to them that way. And there are several different sizes too.
For time's sake, we're just going to pretend I did both of those because I know we're past 3 o'clock. So the last part is going to be boxing the corners.
Do you remember how much this is?
Five something.
Matt, how much is the kiwi? $3.99 for the kiwi cabinet. Woohoo! Thanks, Wendy. Putting that link up there.
All right, so making my... If it really wants to cooperate with me.
Ernestine, what are you saying? Don't understand your comment, my dear.
Okay, so it wants you to mark a 2-inch. I have my pen. Preach. So it's going to be 2 inches from your point here. And then I'm gonna put that one in place. Thank you.
And we're gonna sew along those lines on both sides, and then we're going to flip the bag right side out.
Going slow, going slow. Getting down slow. Donna Chambers says, I just turn my head when you move. Hi, Carolyn. Carolyn Evans, we are not using the butterfly fabric today. It is just a coordinating fabric, so we included it in the bundle. So the bundle comes with this fabric here is your panel to create the bag. The second fabric is the lining that Cindy's using, the striped fabric. And this is a half yard cut. And then you get the butterfly fabric, which is also a half yard cut.
Make yourself like a zipper pouch or...
Yeah, to go with your bag. And this bundle is $18.99.
Something to hold your USB sticks.
Something to use your... Oh, hold your USB sticks. Yeah, you might want to take that out.
And there we go. We've got some box corners and a pretty much finished bag.
Looks great. Fun project. All done in a panel.
From a panel.
How
Who
cool.
Who would have thunk it?
Who would have thunk? Who would have thunk a dunk? And how's your pocket?
What do you mean, how's my pocket?
It's Ernestine wants to see your pocket.
Correct way.
Facing the correct way, stitched down, ready for some lipstick or USB sticks, and then she's going to put my name there. Guys.
Yeah.
Or her own name.
Or maybe next week's winner's name.
Oh, hey.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, thanks for joining.
All right. Thanks, everyone. I guess I'll go over the announcements really quick again. What is today? Monday. Tuesday. Tomorrow is Baby Lot Club. And that is at 10 a.m. And then we have the Main Street Bench Pillow on Wednesday. Thursday, we have the OESD Freestanding Lace event, which is a free event at 10 a.m. You'll learn how to do your freestanding lace struggle-free. And learn a little bit of history about freestanding lace. And then Friday, we have Baby Lock Machine, basic machine class. And yes. How to wind a bobbin, how to thread your bobbin, how to thread your machine, how to care for your machine. Good class. And then on Saturday, we have Floriani Club with Nancy, which is done virtually. Don't want to miss
Another
it.
Another great class. It's a full week.
It is a full week. Yeah. All right. Well, thank you. How do new people get a hold of you? Oh, Sherry Parks. You're not new. So if you are new to watching us, you can feel free to call any of our three locations. We'd love to get your name, your phone number, and your address in our system. That way, if you are interested in placing an order with us, we can know where to ship it to if you are not local, and a way to contact you if we have any other questions. Does the basic... No, she's not drinking a margarita, ladies. If you would like to order, we just ask that you stick with ordering in one way. We have three different options where you can comment on the videos. We just need to have it be known that if there's a color spectrum of the items that you're being shown, to specify which color you're wanting. And if you're local, what store you'd like to pick up at. If it needs to be mailed, you can make a little note on there as well. Or you can place an order online. That is done through our website, aboveandbeyondsewing.com, where you can add items to your cart. And Cindy here does all of the online orders. She's the one who gets to package all of your stuff. So all of the online orders are graced with her touch. or you can call any of the three stores and we can do an order over the phone with you.
Absolutely.
All right. Thanks for watching. Annette, we're going to have to give you a call to let you know if you're signed up for the March Kimberbell fill in the blank program. All right. Thanks, everyone, for watching. Have a wonderful rest of your week. Some of you, I will see you on Wednesday, if not next Monday.
All right. Thanks.
Bye, guys.